Welcome all. We have already started our third lesson, that is addition and subtraction. From that addition part we have seen that day. So now we are going to start the subtraction. Basically you are familiar with 5-digit subtraction. So we are going to see the subtraction which is based on 6-digit and 7-digit. So there are few questions on the board presented. This is 6-digit subtraction, this is 7-digit, and this is also again 6-digit subtraction. So what we are supposed to do and how, that we will see here the board. Okay, so they have told you to minus 978,350. From that, 768,460. Basically, when we are subtracting from the unit place. We are starting from the unit place. So we will proceed further. Just tell me, you are only going to help me out in this particular process. 0 minus 0. Can you tell me what is 0 minus 0? Yes, 0 minus 0 is 0 itself. 5 minus 6, is it 5 minus 6 possible for us? 5 minus 6, is it possible for us? No, it is not possible. So what we are supposed to do? Yes, we are going to borrow 1 from the neighbor side. So this 5 got converted into what? 15, and this 3 gave out it 1 to this 5. That's why 3 we got converted into 2. So now just see now, 15 minus 6, what is the answer? 15 minus 6, yes, it is 9. 2 minus 4 now. 2 minus 4, is it possible for us to subtract? Not possible. If someone gave you 2 chocolates and if another person is asking you for 4 chocolates, if you are only having 2 in your hand, what you are going to give others 4? So it is not possible. So again that 2 is going to borrow from the neighbor. So this 2 got converted into what? 12. Who gave out it 1 number? Yes, this 8 gave out. So this got converted into 7. We are going to go step by step. So 12 minus 4. What is the answer? 12 minus 4? Yes, it is 8. 7 minus 8. Is it possible for us now? Again, no. So what we are supposed to do? Again, that 7 is going to borrow 1 from other place. So this 7 got converted into how much? 17. And 17 means this 7 gave out it 1. So this got converted into 6. So 17 minus 8. What is the answer? Yes, it is 9. And this 6 minus 6, is 6 minus 6 possible for us? Yes, it is possible. So the answer is 0, and 9 minus 7 answer is 2. So our answer is 2,09,890. If you want to cross check your answer, if you want to check whether our answer is correct, what we are supposed to do, I will just tell you one small trick. This number which you got, this answer which you got, you are going to write it down, and this you are going to root off of. I have wrote it down over here. I am going to add the number which I have subtracted. 7, 6, 8, 4, 6, 0. 0 plus 0, 0. I am going to add it. Just see what I did. Whatever answer I got, I wrote. And whatever thing I subtracted, I added over here. This thing which I was subtracted over here, I added in the next term to check whether my answer is correct or not. How? Let's see over here. 0 plus 0 is 0. 9 plus 6 is 15. 8 plus 4 is 12. 12 plus 1 is 13. 9 plus 8 is 17. Plus 1 is 18. 6 plus 1 is 7. And this is 978,350. So whatever we have subtracted, it is correct. So now, we are going to focus on the 7-digit subtraction. Just pay attention how we are going to do it. We are going to start again by the unit place. 8 minus 9 is possible for us? Not possible. So this 8 got converted into what? 18. Okay. This 8 got it 1 from this 2. So 2 gave out it 1. So 2 got converted into 1. Fine. We will proceed further. 18 minus 9 is 9. 1 minus 3 is possible for us? Not possible. So this 7 will give out its 1 and this 1 will get converted into 11. So 11 minus 3 is what? Yes, it is 8. 6 minus 8 is possible for us? No, it is not possible. So what we are going to do? We are going to borrow 1 from here. So 4 gave out it 1, so it got converted into 3. And this 6 got converted into what? 16. So 16 minus 8, what is the answer? Yes, it is 8. 3 minus 0 is okay, possible for us? Yes, it is possible. So 3 minus 0 will be 3 itself. Now focus on the next number. 3 minus 5. 3 minus 5 is possible? Not possible. So we are going to borrow 1 from here. And this 3 got converted into 13. Sorry. My mistake I did. This 3 got converted into 13. Fine. So 13 minus 5, what is the answer? Yes, it is 8. 5 minus 2, what is the answer? Yes, it is 3. And 5 minus 2 again, what is the answer? Yes, it is 3. So our answer is 33,83,818. Again, you can, if you want, you can do the earlier method to check whether this answer is correct or not. You are going to add these two terms and when you are going to see whether the answer is coming, particularly the upper one. Now focus on the next part, that is 4,34,898 minus 2,43,989. What we are supposed to do here? Just see, 8 minus 9 is possible for us, not possible, so this will be 18 and 9 will give out its 1. So that 9 got converted into 8. 18 minus 9, what is the answer? Yes, it is 9 itself. 8 minus 8, what is the answer? 0. So now see over here, 8 minus 9, again it is possible for us, not possible. Okay, so now see, 8 minus 9 is possible for us, again not possible. So what we will do, this 8 will become 18 and who gave that 1 to 8? So yes, this 4 gave, so 4 lost is 1, so this got converted into 3. 18 minus 9, what is the answer? Yes, it is 9. 3 minus 3 is possible? Yes, it is 0. 3 minus 4, is it possible for us? Not possible. So this 3 got converted to 13 and this 4 lost is 1, so this got converted to 3. So 13 minus 4 is 9 and 3 minus 2 is 1. So the answer is 190,909. So there are few questions which are based related or which are based on what problem we will see now. Okay, now just see the word problem which is based on subtraction. How we are going to identify whether it is related to subtraction or addition, that also we will see. Okay, total amount collected for the flood affected people by two organizations was 75,605.25. Total. Is what I have told, there were two organizations, the total contribution which they gave for that flood affected area was 75,68,525. Two organizations where they gave some amount, both the amount when they added, they got the answer that was 75,68,525. Now, if one organization collected rupees 39,19,670 from that one organization, total amount they got something over here. Who gave that total amount? Two organizations. So this one is first, this one is second. From that first organization, from that one of the organizations, it might be first, it might be second, what they gave? They gave 39,19,670. And they have asked you one thing, that how many that second organization gave? Total you are having, and they have told you to, they have gave you one particular answer from it, and they have asked for the second organization. Just keep this question aside. You tell me one thing. If your mother gave 500 rupees for two brothers, if one particular lady is having two sons, A and B, if she gave 500 rupees to both of them, and she told what? 250 you are going to take. Now A son is going to take 250 rupees. How many B will get? Are you going to add again in it? 500 plus 250, are you going to do or you are going to subtract it? Yes, when I am going to subtract 500 minus 250, that time only I am going to get the answer. Same way, I am having the total, particularly fund, I am having the total amount in my hand. One organization gave something and they are asking me some of the other organizations. So obviously I am going to do the subtraction. If I add it, I am contradicting this particular term of total. That's why I am going to subtract these two particular numbers. So what I am supposed to do, just see. Which is the bigger from that? Yes, it is 75 lakhs. So I am just going to write 75 lakhs 68,525 minus 39 lakhs 19,000. 678 and I'm going to subtract it. Basically it is word problem, so writing each and everything is must for you. So 75,68,525 what total amount collected. And what is this 39,19,678? Yes, it was contribution of first or second organization. For just for tentative part, I have wrote that first organization. What I have just see, I have mentioned it, I have wrote down it properly. This was total amount which was collected, and this particular was contribution of first organization. What we are going to find now? Yes, we are going to find out the contribution of the second organization. How? By subtracting. Just see the subtraction. 5 minus 8. Is it possible for us? No. So I am going to do this 15. Who gave that 1 out? So this 2 got gave the 1 out. So this got 2 what converted into 1 itself. 15 minus 8 is 7. 1 minus 7 is possible for us? Not possible. So this 5 will give out 1 and that 1 got added over here. So 1 got converted into 11. 11 minus 7 is 4. And 4 minus 6 is possible for us again? Not possible. So this 4 will get converted into 14. Who gave out 1? So this 8 gave out 1. So 8 got converted into 7. 14 minus 6 is 8. 7 minus 9. Is it possible for us to subtract? Not possible. So this 6 will give out 1. So it got converted into 5. And that 1 got added in this 7. That got converted into 17. 17 minus 9 is possible. So the answer is 8. Now see, 5 minus 1, is it possible for us? Yes, it is possible. So the answer is 4. 5 minus 9 is not possible again. So 5 got converted into 15 and this 7 got converted into 6. 15 minus 9 is 6 and 6 minus 3 is 3. So the contribution of the next or the second constitution or second organization is 36,48,847. So contribution of second organization. Okay, so what is your question? How many rupees did the other organization collected? So your final answer will be other organization collected 36 lakhs 48,847 rupees. Okay, is this clear? Fine. We will see one small concept from this lesson and then we are going to stop. Okay, so last part of this lesson is simplify. So there are three terms in front of you, and in my first term there is addition in between and there is subtraction. So what we are supposed to do, always remember, if this question occurs, you are going to divide them into two parts. And there is one rule called Bodmer's. So what is Bodmer's rule, I will just tell you. This is actually for higher classes, but still it will be essential for you, it will be helpful for you. Just focus over here. B stands for bracket. Bracket of division, multiplication. So bracket of division, this is first, then will be multiplication, then is addition and then subtraction. Always remember, right now you are studying addition and subtraction, so just focus over here. A stands for addition and S stands for subtraction. So always remember one thing, you are going to add first, then you are going to subtract. What you are going to do, you are going to add, then you are supposed to do the subtraction. So now you can see over here, first you are going to add these two terms. Now addition is present between these two terms. So yes, I am going to add them first, and whatever the answer will get, I am going to subtract this particular number from it. If suppose this was minus and this was plus, what was I supposed to do? According to this rule, what is my particular sequence? Addition first, then subtraction. So first I would add. Now which terms I would add? I am going to add these two terms. No, I'm not going to add these two terms. I'm going to add the terms this and this. Why? Because this is having minus in between. These two terms are having minus in between. That's why I'm going to add first. So this term and this term I was adding. And then I will subtract this particular term. Right now our question is telling us this is plus and this is minus. So what we are supposed to do, just see here. First we are going to add them and then we are going to subtract it. So I'm going to mention it properly. 367,580 plus 468,287. And I'm going to add it first. Now see the addition. 0 plus 7 is 7. 8 plus 8 is 16. 5 plus 2 is 7. 7 plus 1 is 8. 7 plus 8 is 15. 6 plus 6 is 12. 12 plus 1 is 13. And 3 plus 1 is 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. So I got the addition. Now instead of this, I got this particular answer. So what I will do now, this one is to subtract. So this answer I will carry forward over here. That is 8,835,867 minus 598,765. Why? Because this term was related to subtraction, that's why. So 7 minus 5, what is the answer? Yes, it is 2. 6 minus 6, it is 0. 8 minus 7, 1. 5 minus 8 is possible for me. Is 5 minus 8 possible for me? Not possible. So I'm just going to convert this 15 and this I'm going to convert into 2. 15 minus 8 is 7. 3, 2 minus 9 is possible. Not possible. So I'm just going to convert these 2 into 12 and this will get converted into 7. So 12 minus 9 is 3 and 7 minus 2, 7 minus 5 is 2. So the final answer is 22,37,102. It's 2,37,102. If same questions come for you to solve, always remember first will be addition, then will be subtraction. Thank you.